Well, good morning. You're watching the breakfast news on Rajya Sabha television. I'm Ashwarya Kapoor with you. All the big news stories from India and across the world coming up ahead. Let us start with the headlines. Rajya Sabha to pay homage to MP and Rajasthan BJP chief Madan Lal Saini. President, Vice President, Prime Minister, top BJP leaders express condolences for Saini, who passed away yesterday. Debate on motion of thanks to the President's address to continue in Parliament. Prime Minister's reply in both houses likely today. BJP fields S. Jaishankar, Jugaljit Thakur for Rajya Sabha by-polls in Gujarat. Nominations closed today for 2 seats each from Gujarat and Bihar, 3 seats from Odisha. Voting on 5th of July. India observes the anti-emergency day. Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu says effective parliament, independent judiciary, accountable executive, free press and informed citizens are important pillars of democracy. And Shakib Al Hasan's 5-wicket haul steers Bangladesh to a 62-run win against Afghanistan, keeps semi-finals hopes alive for Tigers. Hosts England take on Australia at Lord's today. The top story this morning, senior BJP leader and Rajasthan BJP President Madan Lal Saini passed away in Delhi last night. Saini was undergoing treatment at the All India Institute of Medical Sciences after being diagnosed with infection in lungs. Saini hailed from Sikar district and he was appointed as the BJP state president last year. He was a former MLA and RSS volunteer who held various posts in the Bharatiya Kisan Morcha as well. In a condolence message on Twitter, President Ramnath Kovind called Saini a veteran in public life who remained committed to serving those at the grassroots. Vice President and Rajya Sabha Chairman M. Venkaiah Naidu expressed a shock over the sudden demise of senior party leader. Rajya Sabha will also pay obituary reference to the passing away of Madan Lal Saini, sitting member of the House. Prime Minister Narendra Modi expressed grief and said that Saini's death was a major loss for the BJP. Other BJP leaders, including Amit Shah, Rajnath Singh and JP Nadda, have also condoled Saini's death.
दुखद घटना है. राजस्थान से हमारे माननीय राज्यसभा सदस्य रहे, लंबे समय तक उनका सामाजिक सेवाओं में बहुत बड़ा योगदान रहा है. पूरे राजस्थान को इस दुखी घड़ी में शोक व्याप्त है.
वो पूरी की पूरी भारतीय जनता पार्टी के लिए एक बहुत बड़ी क्षति है. बहुत ही साधारण सरल स्वभाव के, बड़ी स्पष्ट तरीके से बातचीत करने वाले, एक ज़मीन से उठे हुए एक कार्यकर्ता, इस तरह का उनका व्यक्तित्व कि जो उनसे मिलता था उनका हो जाता था. इस सरल व्यक्तित्व का जिस तरह से उन्होंने पूरे भाजपा, पूरे राजस्थान की भाजपा को एक तरह से प्रेरित करके इस चुनाव में सबको एकजुट करा, वो सब याद रखेंगे. आपके व्यक्तित्व को सब याद रखेंगे.
And motion of thanks on the President's address will continue in the Rajya Sabha today. The discussion was initiated by Rajya Sabha MP JP Nadda in the upper house yesterday. He said that the government wants not just Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas, but also Sabka Vishwas. Outlining the direction of the government, he told the house that its priority is to work towards improving the ease of living in the next 5 years to further reach out to the commoners in the country.
किसानों को आय दुगनी होगी 2022 तक, ये हमारा संकल्प. हर गरीब को पक्की छत मिलेगी, ये हमारा संकल्प. हर गरीब के पास बिजली का कनेक्शन होगा. हर गरीब को अब खुले में शौच नहीं जाना होगा, सबको टॉयलेट का प्रावधान किया जाएगा. हर को वाटर कनेक्शन, ड्रिंकेबल प्योर वाटर कनेक्शन दिया जाएगा. गंगा की धारा को अविरल रखा जाएगा।
And speaking on the motion of thanks to the president's address, the leader of the opposition, Ghulam Nabi Azad, launched a scathing attack on the government and its policies. Members of the other parties also raised a host of issues while taking part in the debate.
Na mahila padhi in 5 saal mein aur na mahila is desh ki bachi. Aur bachi bhi nahi bachi. जितने बलात्कार छोटी बच्चों के इस 5 साल में देखने आए कभी सुने नहीं थे और देखे नहीं गए थे। नेशनल क्राइम ब्यूरो रिकॉर्ड के मुताबिक 2016 के बाद तो उसकी रिपोर्ट ही आना बंद हो गई। हमने अधिकतर 9 से 10 ऐसी सरकारी एजेंसियां देखी हैं जो हर साल रिपोर्ट छापती थी, चाहे वो सरकार के पक्ष में होती थी, सरकार के खिलाफ होती थी।
मंत्रिपरिषद ने राष्ट्रपति के श्री मुख से जो बातें कहलवाई हैं, जो योजनाओं की चर्चा की है, उन योजनाओं का आकार हमारे देश के आकार से भी ज़्यादा बड़ा है और हमें लगता नहीं कि वे धरती पर सब उतर पाएंगे। अगर उतर जाएँ तो देश स्वर्ग बन जाए। हालांकि ये मीडिया के जरिए, टेलीविजन के जरिए तो उसे सोने की चिड़िया बनाई दिया इन्होंने, वो अलग बात।
द कंट्री टुडे इट इज 40% ऑफ द कंट्री इज विदाउट वाटर, विदाउट रेन। टू मेनी साइक्लोन्स ड्यूरिंग द फास्ट 5 ईयर्स, यू हैव नॉट, प्रेसिडेंट डिड नॉट मेंशन एनीथिंग अबाउट दैट।
गवर्नेंस के इश्यूज मैटर करें या ना करें, बेरोजगारी विकराल है, लेकिन फिर भी आप तसल्ली से जीत रहे हैं। लेकिन ये फॉर्मूला हमेशा काम नहीं आएगा। अगर युवाओं को रोजगार नहीं मिलेगा, अगर युवाओं को गेनफुल एम्प्लॉयमेंट नहीं होगा, अगर आपका असंगठित क्षेत्र ब्लीडिंग रहेगा, अगर आपकी किसानी संकट में रहेगी, तो कतई आप जो कहते हैं ना कि $5 trillion इकोनॉमी, ना जाने कहां से सोच रहे हैं सर।
राष्ट्रपति जी के अभिभाषण में लिखा हुआ है कि फसल, किसानों की फसल दुगुनी होगी, लेकिन कैसे दुगुनी होगी फसल, इसके संबंध में कहीं कोई उल्लेख नहीं है, कहीं कोई उसकी जानकारी नहीं है। राष्ट्रपति जी के अभिभाषण में नोटबंदी से कितना लाभ हुआ शासन को, प्रशासन को कितना पैसा आया, कितना काला धन आया, उसका कहीं उल्लेख नहीं है।
बाबा साहब के संविधान की शपथ लेकर जो भी मेंबर होता है, जो भी मंत्री होता है, वो संविधान की शपथ लेकर वो बोलता है कि मैं संविधान के दायरे में काम करूंगा। पार्टी की फिलॉसफी अलग हो सकती है, पार्टी का सोच अलग हो सकता है, लेकिन एक बार सरकार में आ गए तो सरकार ने बाबा साहब के संविधान के मुताबिक ही आगे चलना चाहिए।
एक सुई के नोक के बराबर भी काला धब्बा श्री नरेंद्र मोदी जी के सरकार के किसी भी मंत्री के ऊपर या किसी पर लगा नहीं। 5 साल बीत गए, 5 साल की जो सरकार थी श्री नरेंद्र मोदी जी की, वह इसी आधार पर थी कि जो भ्रष्टाचार है उस भ्रष्टाचार को दूर करने के लिए हम एक ऐसे व्यक्ति को भेजना चाहते हैं जो भ्रष्टाचार को खत्म कर सके।
आपके लिए कृति मिश्रा इज नाउ जॉइनिंग अस लाइव फ्रॉम पार्लियामेंट। वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग कृति। टॉकिंग फर्स्ट अबाउट राज्यसभा टुडे, द डिबेट ऑन मोशन ऑफ थैंक्स टू द प्रेसिडेंट्स एड्रेस इज टू कंटिन्यू, but you know there is an unfortunate news of the death of MP and Rajasthan BJP chief Madan Lal Saini. What is expected in the upper house today?
Well, Ashwara, as per convention, when the house is in session and a sitting member dies, the house pays obituary, the house pays tribute, and the house gets adjourned. Of course, the motion of thanks on president's address, that was expected to continue in the house, but now it is expected that the house will pay tribute to the member Madan Lal Saini and will get adjourned. Remember, across political spectrum, people are paying tribute to him. Prime Minister also remembered him and he said that it is a huge loss for the BJP. In fact, Home Minister Amit Shah and also the President of the BJP remembered him as Jan Sevak. Many others remembered him as a dedicated social worker and able parliamentarian. So it is expected that the House would get adjourned and his mortal remains would be consigned to flames in Sikar. So the House is expected to pay tribute to him today and then get adjourned. Over to you, Aishwarya.
All right, Kriti, you stay with us. We also need to discuss about Lok Sabha. Well, discussion on the motion of thanks on the President's address will also continue in the Lok Sabha today. The motion was moved by BJP MP Pratap Chandra Sarangi on Monday amid protests by the opposition. Sarangi highlighted the success of several developmental initiatives by the Narendra Modi government. And Congress MP Adhir Ranjan Chaudhary alleged that the NDA government has only renamed the schemes launched by the earlier UPA government.
The youth of India would have ample opportunities to express their abilities and to fulfill their dreams, where the women would have free access to, women would feel secure to pursue their career and interest and live a life with dignity and honor. It would be an India free from terrorism, communalism, casteism, corruption, nepotism, starvation and exploitation.
हर बच्चे को अधिकार है बिजली का, हर महिला को अधिकार है गैस सिलेंडर का. इन्हीं बातों के कारण लोगों ने मोदी जी पर विश्वास जताया और 282 से 303 की संख्या आज हमें इस देश में.
This सरकार has developed a new syndrome which may be called a political plagiarism. It's a government that may be called compliment addicted government. Earning compliment by manipulating the facts.
Because a lot of farm laborers are craving for job opportunity because there is no water, there is no irrigation water. That is why, especially in Tamil Nadu, people are suffering, especially the Delta people. They are suffering for want of Kaveri water.
This government is destroying institutions. Madam, there is cultivation of hate in this country. Kashmir has been mishandled. Only in this year, 88 civilians have died in Kashmir. That is not mentioned.
Let's go back to Kriti Mishra joining us from Parliament. Kriti, we saw a debate on a motion of thanks to the President's address began on a really combative mode in Lok Sabha yesterday. Members of both the Treasury and opposition benches were engaged in competitive credit-taking, each side claiming credit for India's achievements. What all is expected in the lower house today?
Aishwarya, Article 87 of Constitution provides for President's address to joint sitting of both Houses of Parliament, then follows discussion and motion of thanks on President's address. So yesterday we saw both in the Rajya Sabha and the Lok Sabha discussion on motion of thanks, wherein the government and the BJP took credit for several schemes. They also said that the government is committed to Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas. They also listed out the achievements of the Modi government, while the opposition found faults in many of the government schemes and also the programs. Now today it is expected that Prime Minister Narendra Modi would actually make a reply in the Lok Sabha. Remember, discussion on motion of thanks is concluded with Prime Minister's reply on the concerns raised by the members of the House. So then it is expected that there will be voting on motion of thanks and then the motion of thanks would be adopted. Over to you, Aishwarya.
All right, Kriti, thank you so much for all those updates there from Parliament. We'll keep coming back to you in the subsequent bulletins. Let's get you some other news now. The BJP has named External Affairs Minister S. Jayashankar and OBC Youth Leader from Mehsana, Jugalji Thakur, as its candidates for Gujarat Rajya Sabha polls. Now, by-polls for the seats were necessitated following the resignations of National President Amit Shah and Union Minister Smriti Irani, who were elected to the Lok Sabha. Both Jayashankar and Thakur will file their nominations today. Meanwhile, two ruling BJD candidates and one BJP nominee also filed their nomination papers for the by-election to the three vacant Rajya Sabha seats of Odisha on Monday. While BJD's Amar Patnaik and Susmit Patra filed their nomination papers for the two Rajya Sabha seats in the presence of Party President and Chief Minister Naveen Patnaik in Bhubaneswar. And BJP candidate Ashwini Vaishnav also submitted his papers with a returning officer. These three seats fell vacant after BJD's Achyuta Samanta, Pratap Keshri Deb and Soumya Ranjan Patnaik resigned from Rajya Sabha after being elected to Lok Sabha and State Assembly in the recently concluded general elections. Today is the last date for filing of nominations for the by-polls, and polling, if required, will be held on 5th of July. And news from Odisha now, where the first session of the 16th Odisha Assembly is set to begin from today. The Naveen Patnaik-led Odisha government will present its budget for 2019-20 on 28th of June. BJP is the main opposition party in the Odisha Assembly for the first time. And the BJP has named Pradipta Kumar Naik as the leader of the legislature party in the Odisha Assembly. And the nation is observing an anti-emergency day today to mark the 44th anniversary of the proclamation of emergency in the country. It was on 25th of June 1975 when President Fakhruddin Ali Ahmed, upon advice by Prime Minister Indira Gandhi, declared a state of emergency under Article 352, suspending democratic freedom and rights of the people. The state of emergency ended on 21st of March 1977. And in a tweet, Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu said that an effective parliament, independent judiciary, accountable executive, free press and informed and responsible citizens are important pillars to protect and preserve the rights guaranteed under the Constitution. He also urged the younger generation to be eternally vigilant to protect democracy, freedom and rights of fellow citizens. And Prime Minister Narendra Modi tweeted saying that India salutes all those who fiercely and fearlessly resisted the emergency. He added that India's democratic ethos successfully prevailed over an authoritarian mindset.
लोकतंत्र आपातकाल में क्या कुछ जुल्म नहीं हुए थे, इससे बड़ी धमकियां क्या होती है? लेकिन ये देश झुका नहीं था।
1975 25 जून वो ऐसी काली रात थी जो कोई भी लोकतंत्र प्रेमी भुला नहीं सकता है, कोई भारतवासी भुला नहीं सकता है। एक प्रकार से देश को जेल खाने में बदल दिया गया था, विरोधी स्वर को दबोच दिया गया था। इटर्नल विजिलेंस इज द प्राइस ऑफ लिबर्टी, लोकतंत्र के प्रति नित्य जागरूकता जरूरी होती है और इसलिए लोकतंत्र को आघात करने वाली बातों को भी स्मरण करना होता है और लोकतंत्र की अच्छी बातों की दिशा में आगे बढ़ना होता है।
And an event to mark the 44th anniversary of the proclamation of emergency was held in New Delhi on Monday. A discussion on emergency, the darkest hour in Indian democracy, was held in the event that was organized by the Vivekananda International Foundation. And speaking at the event, Prasar Bharati Chairman A. Surya Prakash said that the truth of the emergency days must reach every citizen, and that is why it is necessary to bring out the report of the Shah Commission in public domain. Chairman of the foundation, S. Gurumurthy, said that every citizen participated in the fight against emergency. He said that the Indira Gandhi government not only suspended the rights of citizens, they also imposed a ban on media, where they were not even allowed to publish stories related to the proceedings of parliament.
अब 44 साल हो गया और मुझे लगता है कि इमरजेंसी या आपातकाल, इसे हम सीखने का बहुत कुछ चीज़ है। हमारे लोकतांत्रिक व्यवस्था, हमारे संविधान, इसको हम कायम रखना है। इसलिए उस 19 महीने जो हुआ 75 दशक में कभी नहीं भूलना, और जो विलन्स ऑफ इमरजेंसी है कभी माफ नहीं करना। आप उसको माफ किए तो कल ये दोबारा और कोई ऐसे सोचे तो आप क्या कहेंगे, ठीक है? तो वो पीढ़ी जो है, जो वो अनुभव किया है, और अगले पीढ़ी जो है, सब हम सोचना चाहिए। इसलिए शाह कमीशन रिपोर्ट जो है उसको अब दोबारा हम रीप्रिंट करना चाहिए, हर एक भाषा में होना चाहिए और हर एक कॉलेज में, कॉलेज स्टूडेंट्स जो है वो उसको पढ़ने के लिए हम वो करिकुलम में लाना चाहिए, ये बहुत जरूरी.
So we must understand that all this we must educate the people on. It is not vote-based democracy. It is culturally we are ingrained in the democratic spirit. And that is what made the ordinary Indian fight emergency. Not the man who had read the constitution, who knew the Supreme Court, or who knew how the parliament functions, or who even read the newspaper. It is not that man who fought and won against the dictatorship which was imposed in 1975. But it is the ordinary Indian, the credit goes to him.
And now on to our budget special segment, where we focus today on the automobile sector. Now, India's automobile industry is the world's fourth largest. But after a near decade growth, high growth, the industry witnessed a slowdown. And last month, the Society of Indian Automobile Manufacturers announced a 17% decline in the passenger vehicle sales for the month of April, which was the lowest in nearly 8 years. Now, as the government prepares to bring out the full budget for 2019, the sector has huge expectations that its growth would be revived.
The automobile sector employs 32 million people across the country, directly or indirectly. It is considered the single largest engine of economic growth across the world. But in India, passenger vehicle sales posted their steepest drop in nearly 18 years in May. Weak demand and liquidity crunch faced by non-bank vehicle financiers have prompted major automakers to cut production. Sales fell 20.6% in May to 239,347 vehicles from a year earlier. To boost production, the automobile sector is seeking a GST rate cut on all categories of vehicles to 18% from the current 28%.
As we go along next year, we are also facing the prospect of moving to the BS6 emission norms. There are new safety norms coming up, which is going to raise the cost of vehicles even further. So at this point of time, I think the industry feels the pinch of being classified in the top bracket of 28% of GST. So we feel that at this point of time, the government needs to come out and support the industry very urgently.
The industry is also demanding steps to boost domestic production. One of them is a hike in customs duty on fully imported commercial vehicles to 40%, from 25%.
India is real, and specifically on the auto sector, India has become the hub of small car manufacturing. It has become the hub for three-wheeler manufacturing and definitely a hub for two-wheelers and commercial vehicles. But what is important is a long-term thought-out policy for automotive. We have often seen a lot of statements coming out of various wings of the government which unsettle the auto industry and which therefore discourage a long-term investment policy for the auto sector.
The Indian automotive industry, including component manufacture, is expected to reach $251 billion by 2026. The industry is supported by various factors like availability of skilled labor at low cost, robust R&D centers, and low-cost steel production. The industry also provides massive opportunities for investment and direct and indirect employment to skilled and unskilled labor. Kriti Mishra's report, Rajya Sabha TV.
United States Secretary of State Mike Pompeo will arrive in India today on a three-day visit. The visit, which is the first high-level engagement with the United States after the general elections, is aimed at deepening the bilateral relationship and to kickstart a dialogue towards the resolution of some of the key issues in trade ties. Now, Pompeo's visit comes ahead of a meeting between U.S. President Donald Trump and Prime Minister Narendra Modi on the sidelines of the G20 summit in Osaka, beginning later this week. And during the 3 days visit, Pompeo will hold talks with External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar and also meet Prime Minister Modi. And more news from the United States. President Donald Trump has signed an order on Monday that targets Iran's supreme leader and associates with additional financial sanctions. Donald Trump said that the action follows a series of aggressions by Iran, including last week's downing of an unmanned U.S. surveillance drone. Trump said that he is imposing hard-hitting new sanctions on Iran, including on the office of the country's supreme leader, Ali Khamenei, in response to the shooting down of the U.S. drone and many other things. Trump said that Ayatollah Khamenei, in Iran's highest authority, was singled out because he was ultimately responsible for the hostile conduct of the regime. Iranian Foreign Minister Javad Zarif said that Americans despise diplomacy. In a tweet sent after the announcement, Zarif also accused the Trump administration of having a thirst for war. Tensions between the U.S. and Iran have grown since May, when Washington ordered all countries to halt imports of Iranian oil. Meanwhile, the United Nations Security Council has urged calm and the use of diplomacy. And now news from the ICC Cricket World Cup. Well, Bangladesh beat Afghanistan by 62 runs at Southampton on Monday. And with this victory, the Tigers have kept their semi-finals hopes alive. For Bangladesh, Shakib Al Hasan was the most successful player, claiming 5 wickets and also scoring 51 runs. He was awarded the man of the match. And earlier put into bat first, Bangladesh made 262, losing 7 wickets and chasing the target. Afghanistan were all out for only 200 in 47 overs. And talking about today's match, today hosts England will take on Australia at Lord's in London. The match will be played at 3 p.m. India time. And with that, we wrap up this edition of Breakfast News. Thanks for watching. Have a good day ahead.